So this is the differentiator circuit, which again the design steps have been given to you, the same design I have used over here. So input frequency 2 kilohertz, input voltage plus minus 12 volts, output voltage should be plus minus 10 volts. Now here we are going to give three different kinds of waveforms. If you remember, for a square wave I should get the spikes at the output, rising edge or the falling edge depending on what we are looking at here. Then ramp, the angular waveform, you should get correspondingly square waveforms, and for sinusoidal waveform you should get a cosine waveform. So this is the differentiator design. Let us see for sine waveform whether it really works or not. So yes, so I do have a difference over here. Output is, as you can see, 10 volts, nearly 10 volts peak to peak. Okay, so there is a phase difference. You can see the phase difference over here also, that is almost 90 degrees depending on how I. So this is going to be a 90 degree phase shift corresponding to sine and cosine. Okay, now let us see the output corresponding to a triangular waveform. So the triangular waveform input we have, and the output is a square waveform. Okay, so this is basically differentiating the input signal. What happens to a square waveform? So you can see that there is a rising and the falling spike over there corresponding to these waveforms. So we are actually differentiating the input signal over here. So this becomes a differentiator. So I want all of you to experiment with this. First of all, design and then plot, construct this circuit in multisim and then plot the frequency response, if you have plot the output response. Alright, so that is it.